Greetings. In this video, let's finish examining John 16, verse 7 through 14. What does John 16, 8 through 14 say? And when he is come, he will reprove the world of sin, and of righteousness, and of judgment. Of sin, because they believe not on me. Of righteousness, because I go to my Father, and you see me no more. Of judgment, because the prince of this world is judged. I have yet many things to say unto you, but you cannot bear them now. Howbeit, when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth, for he shall not speak of himself. But whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak, and he will show you things to come. He shall glorify me, for he shall receive of mine, and show it unto you. All things that the Father has are mine. Therefore said I, that he shall take of mine, and shall show it unto you. Look at verse 15 right there. All things that the Father has are mine. All things. What does God possess? The entire universe. Here is Jesus Christ proclaiming before your ears, all things in the universe that the Father has are mine. Mine. They belong to me, Jesus. Therefore I said, he, the Comforter, shall take of mine and shall show it unto you. Let's look again at verse 20. I have yet many things to say unto you, but you cannot bear them now. This seems to indicate Jesus had more to say. Remember, who is Jesus saying this to? Think about it. Who is Jesus talking to when he says this? The disciples. The promise that follows is also being made to the same disciples. He will guide you. He will show you things to come. He shall receive of mine and show it to you, and he shall show it unto you. He will guide you, the disciples, in verse 13. In verse 13 again, he will show you, the disciples, things to come. Verse 14, he shall receive and show it to you, the disciples. In verse 15, he shall show it unto you, the disciples. Remember who Jesus was talking to, the disciples. Would it make sense for Jesus to say, I have many things to tell you, but I'm never going to tell you? Think about it. That is the real reading that Mohammedans have. If they think the Comforter is going to come 600 years after the disciples die. A comforter sent 600 years after the disciples are dead is no comfort at all. Would it make sense for Jesus to say, you cannot understand my message, so I'm going to tell a different people in 600 years? That's not what Jesus said. Jesus said, I'm going to send a comforter, and he is going to receive of mine, and he is going to show it to you. Remember, Jesus said, all things that the Father has are mine. Therefore said I, he shall take of mine, and shall show it unto you the disciples. Jesus is sending the Comforter to teach the disciples. There is an actual reason Jesus said he would send the Comforter. The purpose of the Comforter is to enable them, the disciples, to get and understand the message. The purpose of the Comforter is to enable them so they are witnesses for him. In Acts 1:8, the Bible records, but you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you. That means you've received the Comforter. The Comforter is now present in you as Jesus promised. And you shall be witnesses unto me. both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and unto the uttermost parts of the earth. The Comforter's purpose. The Holy Spirit, the Spirit of truth, is to teach believers the Word of God, to equip the saints to proclaim the gospel, the good news, that Jesus is the Son of God. This is why the Comforter was promised to the disciples and was sent to the disciples. Hallelujah! Is Mohammed the fulfillment of the promise that Jesus gave to send a Comforter? What's the word I'm looking for? No! The Comforter was promised to the disciples. The Holy Spirit was given to the disciples just as Jesus promised. Jesus said who the Comforter was, the Holy Spirit. Jesus promised the Comforter to the disciples. The Holy Spirit was poured out at Pentecost. The Comforter is the Holy Spirit. This was fulfilled less than 2 months after Jesus was crucified and resurrected. There is no chance in heaven or hell that Mohammed is the Comforter spoken of by Jesus. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.